and welcome to the market wrap for Thursday, the 18th of April. And it was a better day for the Aussie market today. We managed to snap a five-day losing streak with the ASX 200 index lifting by around 0.5% or around 36.5 points to 7,642. Now, this was helped by a few things. One was a favourable update on Aussie jobs today, which of course can have implications on upcoming interest rate decisions. We also got a handful of company updates which supported some of the gains, and this also comes after hitting a two-month low in yesterday's session, so certainly some well-received gains today. Across the sectors, we saw 8 of the 11 improving. The materials and tech sectors lifted most. The financial sector also lifting quite strongly, up over 0.7% after 6 straight days of declines, down over 4% in that time frame. On the other side though, we had healthcare retreating most, down by around 0.5%. We also saw telecom and energy down as well. Now, in terms of today's individual winners, cancer treatment firm Telix Pharmaceuticals climbed to a record high and was the top performer today after posting a strong first quarter update, with revenue up 18%, boosted by strong sales of its prostate cancer imaging product. BHP was out with some positive third quarter results as well, and they also likely benefited from a rise in the price of iron ore. Investment manager Challenger lifted after upgrading its full year guidance, and of course we did see NAB and the other major banks lifting today as well. In terms of the losers though, sleep apnea company ResMed was actually the biggest loser, falling almost 6% in the US session last night, down almost the same amount in today's local session, as a new diet drug emerged that could compete with ResMed's business rather. Gold miner Evolution was the second worst after being up strongly in yesterday's session on the back of a strong quarterly update. We did see gold prices easing just a touch last night as well, but of course they are still hovering around record highs. The Reject Shop was lower after trading ex-dividend, set to pay out 10 cents per share on the 3rd of May, and Santos eased after posting a drop in revenue due to factors like bad weather, lower gas prices, and also some maintenance work. Now, looking over to currencies, the Aussie dollar currently buys 64.4 US cents, mixed against other currencies. Looking ahead to tonight, Netflix earnings will certainly be something that investors will look forward to, and also a few more company quarterly earnings coming out tomorrow in the local session, including Pilbara, Woodside, and Whitehaven, which will receive some attention. Have a great night.